So if you want to know which medical schools are harder to get into than Harvard itself, stay tuned. All right, guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Lakshman, internal medicine physician and resident in training. In today's video, we are going to talk all about some of the hardest medical schools to get into, and I'm going to be breaking down some of their MCAT scores, their GPAs, as well as their acceptance rates. So let's get into it. And also stay tuned to the very end of the video, because I'm going to talk about how you can use all of this data to help you possibly get into one of these medical schools if that's your goal. And the data used in this video all come from the US News 2020 report, which I'll link down below in case you guys are interested. But we're going to start from the bottom and work our way up. And at number 10, we have Harvard. Now, you probably weren't expecting me to talk about Harvard right off the bat at number 10, and you're probably now more curious than ever to hear about what schools went from number 9 to number 1, but it just goes to show you that there's going to be a lot of variability in both acceptance rates in the MCAT scores and the GPAs, and again, at the very end, we'll talk about why that's important for you. But at number 9, we have Wake Forest University with an acceptance rate of 3% and a GPA of 3.6, MCAT of 513. At number 8, we have George Washington University at 2.9% with a GPA of 3.6 and an average MCAT score of 512. Now we're back to a familiar name in the Ivy League industry at Brown University with an average acceptance rate of just 3.82% and an MCAT score of 515. Now, to avoid this video just being a bunch of numbers, in case you're kind of wanting to know a sense of reference, the average MCAT score for somebody who gets acceptance to medical school is around a 510, 512. That number will always go up or down depending on the year. The average GPA tends to stick around a 3.7 to a 3.8. So at number 6, we have Howard University Medical School, which most of you guys may be familiar with actual university, which is Howard University, and it's known to be one of the many historically black colleges that we have here in the United States. In terms of acceptance rate, they currently are sitting at a 2.5%. I wasn't able to find a consistent MCAT score GPA for this video, so I just kind of left it out, and hopefully you guys can let me know in the comment section down below in case you do know. And number 5, we are back to a familiar name. We're talking about NYU with an average acceptance rate also of 2.5%, average GPA of 3.93, and an average MCAT, this just blew my mind, of 522. I'm pretty sure I wouldn't get into NYU today if I was to apply. And many of you guys may be familiar with NYU being one of the many institutions that are now kind of releasing this free med school tuition platform, and I'll link down below an article in case you guys are interested in learning more. But to continue to wrap out this list, at number 4, we have Mayo at 2.4%, averaged GPA of 3.92, and another floridly high MCAT score of 520. And our final 3 medical schools in terms of hardest to get into are really just neck to neck in terms of their acceptance rate. But at number 3, we have UCLA at 2.4%, an average GPA of 3.85, and an average MCAT score of 517. At number 2, we have Stanford at 2.3% acceptance rate, an average GPA of 3.87, and an average MCAT score of 519. And so that leaves us with number 1. Now, hopefully you dropped your comments down below, because I know when I saw this institution on this list, I was pretty surprised, pretty floored. But with an average acceptance rate of 2.2%, average GPA of 3.7, and an average MCAT score of 506, we have, drumroll, Florida State University. So as you guys can see, and I'll put it up here, you can see the hardest medical schools to get into based off their acceptance rates. Now, the most important part about this list is not really where the schools are comparatively to each other. There's really 2 things. One, it's about the various lessons you can take away from this list, and 2, how you can use those lessons to ideally increase your chances of getting into whatever school you aspire to go into, whether it be one of these or something outside the top 10. And so here are the various lessons that I was able to take away when investigating this list. Now, number 1, the definition of the hardest medical school to get into is extremely relative. As you guys can see, there's institutions that you expected to be higher or even on the list that weren't, and some schools that you saw on the list that you probably won't even cross your top 10 or 20 in terms of your hardest medical schools to get into. But there's a lot that goes into the acceptance rate that a medical school reports. For example, one, it's going to depend on how many people actually apply to that medical school. So if you have a really competitive Ivy League program, there's going to be a lot of people, and the acceptance rate, understandably, is going to be pretty low. But on the flip side, you may be able to report the same low acceptance rate if, for example, you had a smaller medical school class. So if you had 1,000 people applying to 2 different medical schools, but one medical school could only take 100 people and one medical school could take 200, really the competitiveness and the quality doesn't really say as much. You just know that one medical school may be smaller, thus their acceptance rate looks like they're more competitive. And finally, you have to understand that the acceptance rate also doesn't only take account for how many people apply to the actual school, but also the values that the institution has. And this is really the most important part of this video, so listen up. Keep in mind, there's going to be institutions that have a very specific value of what kind of student they want and what kind of future doctor they want to create. For example, as you can imagine, institution that's associated with a historically black college like Howard University, is going to have a very particular candidate in mind and who they want to make into a future position. And on the flip side, you're going to have institutions that are very driven towards creating researchers and people who can contribute to the scientific community as a whole. And so when you have an institution that has a very specific mindset of who they want to take because of what they can offer that student, that will also go into play of the acceptance rate. So all in all, don't use this list to understand which medical schools you should be applying to or you don't have a chance to get into. Really understand that there is a whole spectrum of what a medical school can offer you and what you can offer them back. And so it is important to start thinking about what type of things you value. Do you want to go into primary care? Do you want to go into surgery? Do you want to go into research? Do you want to go into public health? There are going to be institutions that are very specific to the various goals that you may have as a future physician. And if you don't know, that's completely okay. Just kind of ask yourself what parts of becoming a physician attract you the most, and then ask if the institutions you're most curious of possibly going into are able to offer that kind of experience for you. But this video does fit the theme where I share on this channel to all the pre-meds out there that you don't have to go to an Ivy League program or the hardest medical school ever that existed to become a great doctor. All of the medical schools out there are going to be able to give you the proper training. There are definitely going to be different qualities, and so it's important that you assess it based off of your specific needs. Now, if you're watching this video and you have more pre-med related questions, go ahead and drop it in the comment section down below. I'll also link all of the pre-med related videos that we have here on the YouTube channel and on the podcast down below that you guys can check out. But on that note, if you did enjoy this video and you're interested in watching more pre-med related videos, before you click down on the playlist, consider hitting that subscribe button because we're putting out videos just like this twice a week just for you. And if nothing else, if you can go ahead and just hit that like button down below, I really do appreciate it. Putting this video together definitely takes a lot of work and editing and time and research. And so if you did get something out of it, go ahead and hit that like button. And if you're on your pre-med journey and you would like for me to basically tell you what I would have done if I was in your shoes, then go ahead and check out The Pre-Med Journey, which is a book that I wrote when I was in medical school of all the things that I've basically done and did do when I was in your shoes. And you can find that book on Amazon for just 99 cents. So if you're trying to increase your chances of getting into medical school, check it out down below. And before you click off, if you did enjoy this video, make sure you hit that like and subscribe, and also check out this video to see exactly how hard medical school actually was, and also this video to see all the essential tools you'll need as a future doctor. But with that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully I was a little help to you on your journey. Thanks for being a part of mine. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.